Now, for a sports person, there's no greater honour than representing your country at the Olympics. But for one of our top athletes, that dream has been stolen.
It was the team that sent Australia into a frenzy in the lead up to Paris.
Go the Aussies! We love you guys back home.
But for Matildas veteran Aivi Luik, it was one of the darkest times.
What I read, it just made my heart drop, my whole world stop.
The team's star defender forced to rule herself out of consideration for the Olympic squad, a hamstring injury blamed at the time. But behind the scenes was a different story. Aivi in the throes of fighting a three-month doping suspension.
I received an email out of the blue. It was from Nardo Italia, which is the anti-doping body in Italy, and they were charging me with an anti-doping law violation.
The charges date back to 2022, when Luik was playing for Italian club Pomigliano and was treated for a back injury.
Went to this appointment and realised quite quickly that they wanted to give me an injection. So I asked the doctor, I'm an athlete, I have to abide by anti-doping rules. Are you sure that this is okay? And he said, yes, it's fine.
The painkiller contained a substance banned by the World Anti-Doping Code, but allowed with an exemption, except that her club reportedly filled out the wrong paperwork and the application was rejected.
To suggest that this is an anti-doping rule violation is very odd, because normally that only comes up where there's been a positive test, and as I understand it, there was never a test conducted in this case.
In May, Aivi lost her case against the Italian Anti-Doping Tribunal, who claimed that although she did not intend to commit a violation, there was negligence on her part. And although she planned to challenge the ruling, it would be too late for the Olympics.
I was just so scared of the thought that maybe something like this comes out during the Olympic tournament and what that would do for the girls.
Aivi, now battling to have the charge thrown out, determined to clear her name.
We are live from the lands of the Kulin Nation. You might have glimpsed Tracey Holmes in that story. She's the host of the Sports Ambassador podcast, where Aivi Luik broke that story, and Tracey's with us now. Tracey, I don't know if I've got this right or not. Is this just a paperwork error, or is there something more going on here?
Well, I think, Waleed, it started as a paperwork error, but unfortunately it's escalated to something much, much bigger than that, and that is you have an athlete who has done nothing but abide by every single rule, and to this point it looks like she may be referred to as a doping cheat for the rest of her life, unless she can clear her name. So it might have started as an administrative error, a complication of paperwork that nobody bothered seeing through to the end. And now what we see is the person at the end of the chain, which always ends up being the way, the lone athlete that has to pay the price.
Well, it's a good point, isn't it? Aivi's doctor said it was okay. The club said it would fill out the paperwork. This happens the world over with athletes who put trust in team officials. But it's Aivi that pays the price. Is that how the system is designed to work, or has to work, to make sure that actual drug cheats are caught?
No, I don't think so, Liz, and I think you don't think that either. And I think the system was set up to protect clean athletes. Now, you would have to say, with all that we know, Aivi Luik is a clean athlete. She did not break any single rule. The rules that were broken kind of happened around her with this administrative nightmare, this institutional nightmare. And then because it was so close to the end of her contract, she gets up, she leaves the team, she moves on to another club in another country, not thinking that there was anything still unravelling behind the scenes. 2 years later, on the eve of the Olympic Games, she finds out, well, unfortunately, it has all unravelled. Nobody has taken charge of this. Nobody did provide the correct paperwork or send it to the right department. And now she has not only paid the price with this doping suspension, but being robbed of the opportunity to play with the Matildas at the Paris Olympic Games, potentially her last opportunity to do so with the national team.
Tracey, there'll be people watching us scratching their heads, because, I mean, even just most recently, the Chinese swimmers were cleared after their claims of a contaminated kitchen. The world number one tennis player most recently was cleared after claims of he had been contaminated by his physio. Why do they get off and Aivi doesn't?
Well, I think we have to be very careful about the language we use around these things, and I follow these anti-doping cases very, very closely. The Aivi Luik case is a very different case. So in the case of the Chinese swimmers and with Sinner, the tennis player, there was a positive test. Now, when you read the detail that comes out of these reports and investigations, the positivity is like, you know, it's really a squillionth of a molecule. And so there's no way that in either of these cases they were deemed to be performance enhancing. So I even think to say get off is probably not the right terminology. They were cleared. And I think that is something very different. In the Aivi Luik case, there was no positive test. Basically, what they've said is you use something that potentially could have found you positive if we tested you, so therefore we're going to throw the book at you. So it's a very different scenario, and I think it's, you know, we have to try and keep those two things separate because all things in anti-doping are very complex and there's always a great deal of detail.
Tracey, thanks for taking us through it.
No problem.